Hey guys, Megan Stitching May back for another video. This is not an update video. This is instead my whip parade. I know some of you guys absolutely love whip parades, and then they're the ones that absolutely despise whip parades. Nonetheless, I'm doing one. I did a whole 3 floss tube videos last year, and it's been a while since I've done a whip parade, so I feel like I need to update you guys on where my projects are. Plus, I spent a lot of time counting stitches, and I know how many stitches I put on in which project. I don't know if I'll do a whip parade every year, but I'm doing one this year. So, I currently have, that I will show you, 72 whips. Nothing that I will show you tonight has been touched in 2023. When I show you Tree of Hope, I'm only going to show you a before picture and an after picture, because I have worked on that project. However, I don't want to show it to you with the new stitching because it's not part of the 2022 stitching. Is that clear as mud? Really hot tea and, you know, you cannot. This is my sister's cup. I kind of snagged it from her. I am also going through and changing all of my project tags to these. I was originally using these tags with masking tape, but then, or I don't know which one I was using first. I tried paper tags, but I didn't like the waste, and I also did not like that, well, the cat likes to chew them up. Can you see that? I mean, you can't even see. Peter likes to eat paper. And then I tried these with the masking tape to where I could change it, but it's just not neat enough for me. So now I have purchased these off Amazon. I'm going to try these. So while I do this, I am sitting down, changing out all the tags, going to show them to you. As the section uploads, I will then change the new tags on the new bags. All the while washing clothes and washing dishes. It's been a busy day, but here I am for this. So, in no particular order, I'm just going to jump in. The first one I'm going to show you is Bird Keeper, which I need to keep out because I do need to work on this one this month. This is what she will look like when she is finished. This is my working copy. Of course, she won't be black and white. This is the Good Housewife project. I am stitching this on a linen that I dyed myself. And in 2022, I put in 503 stitches on this. This is where she looked like when she started in 2022. And this is where she was at the end. And like I said, I put in 503 stitches. And this is a fabric that I dyed myself. I'll have a whole other half of this later. This was just a lot of fun dyeing this fabric. I have no clue what I'm doing. I just throw it out there. See what happens. Why does this feel so awkward? Next is Summer Jubilee, and I don't need to put in a starting picture because I don't think I stitched on this one at all. Nope. No stitches, so I won't have to put in a before picture. This is from the Just Cross Stitch magazine, August 2003. I think you can buy the pattern separate too, but mine came from the magazine. This is stitched on. The cough just won't go away. I feel better. The cough just won't go away. Fabrics by LG. LJ. He no longer dyes fabric. I have no clue the colorway. Gosh, I wish he still dyed fabrics. He had some wild colors, but his, when he would do the tonal ones, they were beautiful. And he did a lot of even weave. So this is where it was and where it remained in 2022. I've completed the border, started in on the alphabet there, and then have some of the flower. Guys, I purchased a ring light from the Dollar Tree. It's a whole $5. And it works great. I don't have a tripod that will hold my camera because I don't record with my phone or my tablet. I record with a camera. And the ring light. If anybody knows of a tripod that holds both, let me know. I'm trying to get enough light without washing out the projects. There's going to be zipping, there's going to be rattling, and there's going to be clearing of the throat. I apologize. This is my Lizzie Kate Christmas kit. It was a limited edition kit. This is what it will look like when it's finished. This is what it looks like when I throw it in the floor. It's the complete kit, and I stitched no stitches on this one in 2022. See, I have a lot that I didn't touch in 2022. I'm hoping to remedy that in 2023. My goal is to put 300 stitches on every project. We'll see. This is why I've always had issues with the zipper tags. Stuff gets caught up in the zipper. Okay. Next is Kindred Spirits. I did work on Kindred Spirits. I put in 734 stitches on this one. So this is what she will look like when she's finished. This is a working copy, guys. My original is already spoken for. This is stitched on a 32 count branded apple, Lugana by Silk Weavers. This is where she was at the start of 2022. I'm calling them all she. I don't know why. This is where it is now. And that is with my needle minder from Dina Haptic Stitch Cross Stitch. Earlier, guys, her magnet is so strong that it stuck to my table. I've got a little sewing table. It's just a folding table. Those weird, like a card table, but it's long and narrow. And it stuck to the metal. Like, the whole bag was stuck to the metal. I was like, man, that's a strong magnet. It's holding up my project, my needle, to the table. And I do have statistics at the end, like how many stitches I did total, how many starts I had, and how many finishes. But I'm gonna make you watch the whole thing to see that. This is Christmas Sentiments. This is what it looked like in 2022. Because I did stitch on it, and also what it will look like when it's finished. And I put in a whole whopping 216 stitches in this for 2022. And I can't tell you where the stitches are. You'll know, because you'll see the before picture. And that's just on a piece of lamb's wool fabric. This is Salt Box Neighborhood. This is one that I started with Emily and Dana Bexton on Instagram. I don't think she does floss tube yet. We're still working on that. This was a 2020 start. I remember starting this in 2020. And this was stitched on, so I had an LJ fabric that had a dye spot. It was an imperfect. And I was able to stitch two different projects on this fabric, cutting along the dye spot to put it in the selvage. It was perfect. It's a 32 count even weave. I don't remember the colorway. And I did not work on this in 2023. You see a trend? I either did a whole lot of stitches or nothing at all. And this is why I was on the fence about doing whip parade, because like some of them I didn't touch, but I feel like I need to show them. And I also include pictures of my finishes, if I have them, at the end of the video. This is Santa's Trips. I did stitch on this one a whole 113 stitches. Guys, let me tell you, when you hashtag Santa's Trips, it sometimes looks like Santa strips. Santa's not stripping. He is. That's not good either. He's going on a trip. I have goose hair. Not goose feathers, goose hair. This is stitched on a unknown count color and cascades opalescent fabric. This was gifted to me by Belinda. I don't often stitch on opalescent, but I thought it was perfect for this piece because it's Christmassy and snowy and, you know, my electric teapot is beeping, let me know it's turning off, that it's no longer going to hold heat. I have been too long to make my tea. Next is Way to Happiness. This is a project. It's a free sal by Jardin Privé. You can get it on her website. If I remember, I'll link below. There's no way I can do every single link for these videos, for these projects. I started this with Connie G Stitches, or Connie G. She no longer makes floss tube videos. And this is the other half of that LJ fabric that worked out perfectly. I didn't stitch on this in 2023, so I don't need to show a before picture. Making sure. I have converted this to my own color and cotton and various threads that I have. I'll show all those in more detail later. This is just showing the width. I asked my son if he wanted me to help me do a whip parade, and he said, "What do you mean?" I said, "Well, I show my whips." He's like, "Your whips?" This is Whirls by Connie G Designs. Squirrel moment. When I was a child, I had a speech impediment, and R's were one of the words that I had an issue with. To this day, words, names like Roy, R-O-Y, or when I watched Gilmore Girls, Rory, gave me an issue. Words that have W and R's in them, I still have to make a conscious effort. I mean, it's a conscious, unconscious, you know, like I don't realize that I'm doing it, but I am. It's not a natural sound. So this project name, Whirls, I have to think about before I say it. Complete squirrel. So this is what it will look like when it's finished. This is one that I have adopted from her, and I've not stitched anything on this. It was a whip that I adopted and included in my whip list. So this is stitched in a Mohs Sail floss. This beautiful turquoise and green that's showing up perfect. I think I like this light. And it looks like it's on a 32 count even weave in ivory. She's marked the top and she's even gridded it. So that is where she was. And then I will take over. And again, I'm going to have to do like I do with Nightmare. Turn it on its side because she stitches the right way. And I don't. I stitched the wrong way. Already got patterns left out. But I've not stitched on this at all. I will soon. Funny story about the speech. I was in speech classes when I was in elementary school. In Small World, my husband's best friend was in speech class with me. So we knew each other before we knew each other through Scott. And my husband actually ended up coming to, they would let us bring a friend. And Scott came to one of our classes one day. He was also in a guitar club. Our school counselor would, he remembers it. I remember the guitar club. I don't remember meeting him there. But he already played, and our counselor would help have him help teach the other kids. And apparently he paired us up one day. He said he remembers my red hair and that I was really bad. So, serendipity, there were just little times in our life that continued to try to get us to meet. So, this is Power of Love. The Power of Love. This is a Stony Creek design. I stitched this one about the time of the Ukraine wars. I loved it, or the Ukraine war started. The saying, when the power of love overcomes the love of power, the world will know peace. It just felt appropriate. So I did stitch on this year. It was a new start, and I put in 525 stitches. So I don't need a before start picture, because there was no before. This is stitched on the called for DMC. And I think it even has a Threadworks. It does have a Threadworks, and I had it in my stash of all times. And this is stitched on a 20 count, right? 20 count? Yes, 20 count vintage country mocha. And that is where I am. Started on a border, kind of got the leaves in. Okay. Next is Pandemic by Long Dog Samplers. I keep leaving parts of the charts and stuff out. This was a 2020 start. Dare I say I would love to finish it this year, but who knows if it will really happen. This, of course, is a PDF, so this is a printout. I got this when she was still offering it for free. This is what it looks like when it's finished, except I am stitching this in a sulky thread, 12-weight thread. I have two spools, so I probably have too much. It's in peacock. It's got these beautiful grays and greens. Blues and greens. It is called Peacock. And this again is stitched on 20 count. I think this is just 20 count sand, Ada. It was in timeout for a while. In 2020, I had stitched on it and dropped something and had to frog and didn't want to frog because it was one over one. Because with this 12 weight, you use one thread and it's about the equivalent of two DMC. I wouldn't do this on like a 14 count as two, but for a smaller count, it's more probably like one and a half. But I finally picked it back up. And I love it. I love, love, love this thread color. And I put in, where it was before, 666 stitches. That's where I am, guys. This thread color. I love the way it works up. And of course, the Plague Doctor Needle Miner from Vic Stitch and Button. We can't not use the Plague Doctor needle minder on the pandemic sampler. And apparently, the story is she had planned to release this before the pandemic happened. And it was just serendipitous. That almost doesn't fit in this bag. Okay, I gotta speed up. I thought I was going to do 25, but apparently I'm not going to make it all the way through to 25 for each section. This is Quaker Seasons. This is one that, when I was first cross-stitching, I saw the model in a store and fell head over heels in love with it, but was intimidated by it because of the specialty floss. It's Week Style Works, guys. Week Style Works. Didn't get it for the longest and finally went back and got it. This is what it looks like when it will finish. This is one that I started in 2020. I know it was May of 2020. And I did stitch on this one. I put in a whole 118 stitches. It is stitched on, oddly enough, the called for fabric. So when I kitted this up in 2020, I live chatted with my son and my husband saying, hey, I can't figure out which fabric, which one do you think? My son said this one, and it ended up being the called for fabric. It's on 32 count Belfast linen in the colorway Antique Ivory. This was a saying, to everything there is a season, a time, to every purpose under heaven. That was read at Ecclesiastes, was read at my uncle's, my mom's, and my aunt's funeral. So I started it in May, and I've got this wonderful needle minder, an angel needle minder with diamonds in it, or rhinestones, but you know, come on, focus, focus. That was gifted to me by the lovely Marlene, Stitching by the Lake. And I put it on here. Diamonds are my birthstone. And it's for my mom and my aunt. And they're my angels. So, or I hope they're my angels. Bless their hearts. And I am stitching this in the called for threads. This one is in timeout. I already know which one this is, and I'm going to have to frog it whenever I start to stitch it. So it's in timeout because I'm not ready to frog it. Even with the ones that I'm going to have to frog, this is Haunted House Sampler. I put in 425 stitches on this one. This is what it will look like when it's finished. This was a Twin Peak Primitives. It was like a limited edition kit. And then it got so much love that they went back and they released just the pattern. So. This was started in Halloween in 2020. It is on a toasted almond. I want to say this is a silk weaver. It is. Ha ha. Edinburgh Linen 36 count Antique Almond by Silk Weavers, guys. I love... No. Is it? Yeah, this is. I'm pretty sure this is Silk Weavers. Just in case. I love Silk Weavers fabric. It is ridiculous trying to get it from them if you have to order. So this is where I am. I'm going to have to frog this motif. It is, I think, this and everything to the left of it. I think I'm gonna have to look and see. I got mad and just put it down. It's too high or too low, or yeah, it's too high. This is all I think. A little stitch too high. I think it's supposed to be centered up with the letters. Yeah, that's what it is. So all of this has to come out, and I haven't done it yet. And I am stitching it 2/2 and the called for DNC. And I love the way these colors pop on this fabric. So I will pull it back out and love it again. And then this is the needle minder that I'm using from Vic Stitch and Button. I love black cats. She joked when I got this one. She said, except for mine. Because that's when Vader was being a jerk. He's calmed down a lot. Goose has helped him calm down a whole bunch. He's just mean to Goose now. We have to watch for that. In about 5 more minutes. I'll get one more in. This is calling... No, I'm going to do that one. I'm not going to rush that one. This is Flower Quaker by Verbena Designs. I got this. She was doing a thing where she was giving out a pattern of your choice from her Etsy shop. I don't think she's on Etsy anymore. I think she does have her own site. I'm stitching this in the Called For DMC on 32 count unnamed Witchelt fabric. I did stitch on this one this year. I put in 236 stitches, so this is what it looked like before. This is what it looks like now. I realized in my last video that I was holding the piece up backwards for a little while. I swear I've done these videos before. It doesn't feel like it. It feels like this is a brand new video. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Stitching May. And I'm going to pause here so that my video doesn't cut me off on its own. I'm going to go ahead and be uploading this to my video editor while I continue on with the rest of my pieces. Be back. So, it's been a really long time since the last section. Not for you guys, it's just been a matter of seconds. Basically, I realized my numbers, some of my numbers were weird. Fix that. I didn't have all the photos I needed. Well, I did, but I didn't. Fix that. Recorded a whole 30-minute session. Went to upload it to the computer so that I could take it off the card and all that fun stuff. Because I'm kind of editing as I go and cleaning up as I go. To where, hopefully, this wasn't going to be a 4-hour video making. But then, when I went to do whatever, I deleted the video that I had just made. And I didn't realize it until I had... When I went to edit and I had the same video twice, I couldn't figure out what I had done. I understand now, and I'm ready to continue on. Anyway, hey, you know, I've done this forever. This feels still like my first video. This is my welcome back, I guess, you know? Hi, I'm Megan. I'm learning how to make videos because I still don't know what I'm doing. So, in the meantime, I have labeled a bunch more project bags because I had done, you know, a second part of the video. Put them away, and then had to figure out and get them back out. So, some of this may feel like it's been said before for me, some deja vu, but nonetheless, my tea is cold, I've had a snack, my kid's asleep, been asleep. He's been having some stomach issues lately. I was kind of afraid he was going to get sick, but he's okay. I'm just going to jump on in and keep going. A lot of these, I realized in the first recording of this, seem to be the ones that I didn't work on. So I worked on 43 projects and I did not touch 41 projects. With that said, I think most of these are the ones that I did not touch. I'm going to have to let this cat in, otherwise he's not going to let me do this video. He'll start smacking the doorknob in a minute. With that said, the part two originally recorded a lot faster because I didn't have like a before and after. It was just kind of where I am now. So with that said, let me let this cat in. So I'm back. The cat is in here wrecking havoc. Here, you can play with those. He wants in my lap, but the table's in his way and then he doesn't want me to hold him. So he's fidgeting a temper tantrum. Anyway, you may hear him snort, you may hear meow. He's very vocal, and he breathes loud. He's fine, though. So, like I was saying, I accidentally deleted part two. So some of this is like, I feel like it's been said, I don't know. This part's probably going to go a little faster, though. So I've been watching it FlossTube more lately. I'm really excited to see that some of the kind of OG FlossTubers are back. And I saw one today, Joe Gregario. Gregoria, I can never say her last name. And she is stitching on this, or starting this. It is the Quaker Alice by RETM Designs. I think it's her whip. It's her whip. And she was talking about it, and I was like, hey, look, I'm working on that. We should kind of make it a, it's not a sal, because we didn't start it together, but we can work on it at the same time. And so here's mine, Joe. I have stitched. I've not touched it at all this year. It is on, I want to say, Diamond Sapphire Fabric by Wichelt. What, bud? You can get up here. And this is a needle minder by a company that no longer makes needle minders. I will not name them because I don't make them. You hear him? That's Alice Quaker. I'm gonna watch my time. Next is the Crip Club. This is this one's birthday, so I need to move it over there. And I did not stitch on this one at all this year either. So I'll insert what, I mean, I don't need to insert what it looks like before. I do have what it will look like when it's finished. This again is a working copy, and I do have the original chart, and it was out of print, but now you can get the PDF. There was somebody that had spoken for this and wanted it, but I think this person has since gotten the PDF. I'll double check and go for them there, and it may or may not be up for grabs. No, I'm sure I got some of that. So I am stitching this on 32 Count Meyer by Picture This Plus. Guys, this is the perfect Halloween fabric. Who's trying to figure out who I'm talking to? Like, I don't normally stitch on such variegated. Like, I'm more of a prim and then kind of shades of the same color fabric. Oh my goodness, like, this is amazing. And it's perfect for Halloween. Now Vader's trying to get in. And for whatever reason, I have a Christmas and needle minder on here that was gifted to me by Miss Connie. I have no clue why that's the one that's on there, but it is. These cats. It is time for them to settle down, and they usually end up in my lap, in here in my lap while I'm stitching. This is usually when I'm stitching, so. And I'm stitching this in the Called For DMC. Let me let this cat in. Hopefully, we won't have any more unnecessary interruptions because I'm starting to just want to be done for the video. Moving along. Singing the Blues. This is one that I did not stitch on in 2022. Because I don't even know if I can figure out which way is up. I think this way is up. Look. Like, I don't even know if that is going to get to count as a whip or not, because it doesn't have 100 stitches in it. I mean, it's been on my whip list for years, so I guess it does, but technically, which is a half, preferred 100 whips. Anyway, that's the whole thing. Rules we make with our friends. Next is Quiet Quaker. I did stitch on this one. I put in, this is what it looks like when it's finished. It was English, I swear. This is where it was before. And this is where it is now. This is stitched on a piece of fabric that was gifted to me by Emily. Her stitching is still on the side. It was a Barber Anna design that she decided not to do on this particular fabric. I've not frogged it out. I will, because this piece is not going to even take up half of it. So this is where I currently am, and I have put in 768 stitches. This is a freebie by Needle Press Ink, I believe, on a blog. The next time I show it, I'll link to it. Because again, there are way too many whips for me to try to show, to link everything. This is a Wilchelt or Zweigart fabric, and it's just, this is the color it comes in. It's not dyed. And, I mean, or they dye it. And I'll find out the color, and I'm stitching this in. It's 32 count, 2 over 2, and ecru by DMC. I just like the turquoise and the ecru. I thought that was really pretty. Next is United We Stand, another one that I did not stitch anything on in 2022. This is what it will look like when it's finished. This was a Teresa Kogert design that I started in 2020. And I picked out my own color and cottons. And this is where I am. This is a piece of random Zweigart 32 count linen. And I'm not sure where this needle miter came from. But that is where this one is. I'm going a lot faster. Maybe the interruptions are helping. I don't know. Cat's gotta love them. Next is Good Intentions. Because I do have good intentions. But you know what they say about good intentions. I did not stitch on this one, despite my good intentions, in 2022. So this is what it looked like at the beginning of the year. I'm not sure. I know this is 32 count linen. I want to say this might be mellow. I don't, but then it's not printed on the back. It's maybe a fabric flare piece. It's kind of vanilla-y. Modeled vanilla. I'm going to call it vanilla ice. And that fabric, that needle minder is a one that I got there in Stiach along with, I was on Team Fireball, so. Next is Christmas Countdown. I did show this in my last video. I did work on this in 2022. A whole 114 stitches. Hang on, guys. I feel better. I still have the cough, and it's worse at night. This is a Dimensions kit, so I'm stitching it on what it's called for and what it came with. It's 18 count Fiddler's Ada with the kit fab or floss. It does have blend. Stitch and Button purchased the other day some really neat floss cards, chips that have two holes for blend. So, like, if you put both of your flosses, I'm going to have to look for that because I think that would help a lot in this project. This is where I am. I am still undecided on if I'm going to stitch the entire thing and make it, flossy beachy nose, an actual advent, or if I'm just going to stitch the top. Right now, I'm leaning to just the top. The only part that I stitched was right there in that corner. But you probably saw that in my last video, if you watched my last video. Oh, Vader. Sorry, bud. Incoming. Next is Daisy Vase, which I also showed on my last video. And it's another one that is the kit floss and the kit fabric. This is an Design Works. Don't know who actually Christopher Pierce is who the artwork is by. The only thing I've changed is the copper metallic. I changed to a silver Krennic number 4 braid. I think it's like 0110 or something. Just the basic silver Krennic. And that is where I'm fitted. And I put in 471 stitches this year on this piece. It's not like a lung cough. It's an itchy throat cough. Next is Spangled. I did not touch this one this year. Oh, no. I did. See, I'm getting into the ones that I had not shown. This one is a sow with myself, Sammy Joe, and Belinda. And they both mentioned in their whip parades that they wanted to work on this more this year than they did last year. So that then, of course, makes me have to do the same. So I will. So this is what it will look like when it's finished. Pardon my faded printer. It's darker than this. I am stitching this on, this is what it looked like before. And I'm stitching this on a 36 count Rollin, and this was my first piece of 36 count that I ever stitched on. I don't know how I remember that. And it's also my first long dog sampler. Long dog sampler. I said dog, right? Yeah, I said dog. This is where I am. And this is actually the backer of a needle miter that I had that I'm using as a needle miter because I don't like that on the back. I just like the plain flat magnet on the back. I actually started getting into some of the sampler some instead of just the border. But that border is so fun, but so heavy. But I love this piece. Like, every time I pull it out, I'm like, I don't want to stitch on this more. I don't want to stitch on this more. Next is Calling Birds. This is the one, I did show this one in my deleted part two. But it, I had the stitches for this one on a different project that I haven't worked on. So this is When Calling Birds Sing. It is an out of print, and my original is already spoken for. Somebody wants it. You can sometimes find them on eBay. I did make some changes. You can see on my working copy where I've, so these flowers are red, and with a brown background, you can see where I've got PGRGOB for pink, green, gold, blue. Pink, green, gold, blue. So I took colors from within this pattern and decided to change up the border. I did not like the red and brown. Instead, I made them. And this is a 36 count unknown fabric. I got it off eBay. It's very similar to 611 because I think I had to change that color in this. But, so I've just gone and ordered pink, green, gold, blue, pink, green, gold, blue, and made the flowers that way. And I'm not going to do the background. I'm going to leave it open like that. And I really like the way those colors are coming. And then I've actually gotten into the alphabet some. I put in, on this one, 300 stitches. And I don't know if it's, I know it had a DMC conversion. I'm stitching it in the DMC. Do you like the wall of projects around you, Dana? This is Alton Quakers. This is a stitch along I joined with Gary from Garon. This is what it looked like when it's finished. And I stitched on it, so I have a starting for 2022. I'm stitching it in the Call for Valdani. On the Called For fabric. But I'm wondering, I'm trying to think, I don't know if I got even weave or if I got linen. Look and see. I put in, did I tell you already? 201 stitches in. It's an even weave. This is the bloom. Guys, I've got to get these done. I've got all four of them and started all four and paid for the specialty floss and the specialty fabric. And don't even have a quarter of any of them completed. When you see Winter Quakers, it's strange. But that one was started at a weird time. That was started in 2000. I haven't touched that one since 2019. I started it when we were at home with Connor's kidney issue. Now, this one is one I don't know about. This is the Lindy Mystery Sow. And this is the one that got me thinking, or has me thinking, like, what am I going to do with all these projects when I'm done with them? I enjoy the stitching, but do I stitch for the finished project, or do I care if they languish away? And I'm torn. And this is not one, this is one I like, and I think it's cute, and I love the project. But I don't know that I would hang it up on the wall. And then I hate for this fabric to be languishing away. So I don't, it's not a give up yet, but it's on the fence. It's a, Oh, that's the back. It's her mystery cell. I'm going to do the dinosaur. And this is just get it up in some of my own. It's a very pretty kind of mint opalescent from, I want to say Silkweaver. And, you know, my Silkweaver fabric is precious. And then I just did my own color conversion. I grabbed similar colors. Some of them are Curious Creations, and some of them are Color and Company. I don't think Curious Creations dies for anymore. This is Pilgrims of Plymouth. This was a start with Vic, Stitch, and Button. I keep wanting to call her Vic and Button. I'm just making it up, I guess. My pencil's making a noise. Pilgrims of Plymouth is by Twin Peaks Primitive. She had this scheduled as a start on the day the Mayflower sailed or landed or something. It was a historical day. I started it with her. This is on 20 count vintage country mocha because I had a whole yard of the vintage count country mocha and I've got a whole lot of pieces chopped up into different projects. And of course, this needle miter is from her too. But there that is. And again, didn't stitch on this one. A lot of these I didn't stitch on. Didn't stitch on this one. This one's Jane Marshall. It was a Sal. I don't remember the tag. It's a Hands Across the Sea design. It was done or made with the proceeds went to the bushfires in Australia. So I've just come to a halt on this piece. It's so close to being done. More than almost halfway. But I chose my own colors. And now I'm not second guessing the colors. I like the colorway. But I feel like I need more color. Because I feel like I'm overusing the color. So I've just kind of been stuck. And this year Vic and Belinda are my whip managers. And they're part of the reason I'm doing this whip parade. It's where they can see where I am and see when I say, ooh, I really want to finish this one. Ooh, I really want to finish this one. This year, Vic, need some marching orders. I've just got to figure out what to do about the floss. I may need to add some more colors in. I don't know yet. Haven't stitched on this one either. What's that? Oh, that's the project. It looked weird through the bag. This was a Sal piece from Connie G. I have no clue. I've got all kind of notes in here. And she calls it a back stitch sow. I kept calling it a blackwork sow. It technically is not a blackwork sow because it doesn't have the filler in the motifs. But it's very pretty and it looks like blackwork. I don't know what I have. Got all kind of stuff in this project bag. I literally have 7 motifs left to finish, guys. Stitching this back stitch in 1 strand of DNC 310. This is a Sunny Dyes fabric that you can no longer get. It's beautiful. Further away, I don't know. Maybe it's just because my screen's tiny. But I love it. I love this fabric. This year. You take a note, Vic? Ooh, almost wiped everything out. A poker chip in here. I don't know what all this is. Next is Lo How a Rose. This is one that was a start with Diana. It's Kismet Stitches for Christmas in July. She hasn't made videos in over a year now. This is in one of my Better Home and Gardens books. I want to say Across This Christmas, Christmas Memories or something. Again, when I show it, I'll give the exact details of the designer and all that stuff. I'm stitching this in the Charted DMC conversion because it's got Anchor DMC or Weak Style Works, and I'm doing the DMC. And this is on just a random 28 count piece of linen that I had. And it's see-through, so let me put it on my board. Not much. Not even 25%. Didn't stitch on it this year either. So, my goal last year was to put 500 stitches on every project that I touched. I didn't touch every project, and I didn't put 500 stitches on every project. This year is to touch every project and not put 300 stitches on every project. We'll see. We'll see if that happens. Taking my time. I've noticed that when I focus in on my timer there, like my eyes cross. I think my glasses are a little off. So this is Pumpkin Swirl. This was the piece. So I'm in a group of friends and we choose categories for each other. And anyway, this was the one I was supposed to work on if it didn't fit in any, if nothing, none of my pieces fit in the categories. And I never touched it. So I took it out of that position this year. That way I would actually stitch on it. Because for some reason, I was thinking I would stitch on it more. So I didn't choose it for any of the categories and I didn't touch it at all. Makes sense, right? So I've not touched this in 2022. Pumpkin Swirl. This was gifted to me by Belinda. She bought me the pattern. The threads, the dinky dyes, and the beads. And then this fabric is the same 28 count, no name linen that I had before. Bless you, Goose. Vader is curled up in a ball on his daddy's chair. Goose is cuddling with him. That's all they wanted. They wanted to settle down. Next is Vintage Birds. And again, didn't touch this one this year, guys. So I'm going to do these quicker at least. And the editing will be quicker. This is Jeanette Douglas. It was one that I started for my birthday, Sal, and everybody else finished it, and I'm not done with it yet. This year, guys. I can't finish them all this year, can I? Did my own color and cotton conversion. This is on a it looks like a Picture This Plus. Oh wait, yes, it is Picture This Plus. It's the Called For fabric. But then my own colors, which the Called For fabric was, it's Legacy. Yeah, Legacy. 36 count Legacy. And this is barely gonna, that's the back again, barely gonna fit, but it's gonna fit. One of the rare times I actually have the working original with it. I usually don't keep my original. I got a whole notebook over there that's got all my originals in it because I'm so hard on stuff. As evidenced by random patterns and random project bags and some kind of note that I don't even know what it was. I gotta look and figure out what that note is. Next is Prairie Schooler Santas. Okay, so I have all of the Prairie Schooler Santas. I started out in 2022 with the 1984 Santa started. I finished 1984. I'll show that later. I started and finished 1985. I'll show that later. And then now I'm working on the 1986. I'm doing these in the Called For DMC on 25 count new khaki Lugana or mushroom or tan, whatever I can find, because it's hard to find the new khaki 25 count Lugana. I've got a big chunk. I've cut it up in two pieces. I've got still a larger chunk and I keep the one I'm stitching on, and then the next piece of fabric in the back, because this one, this particular pamphlet had four designs on it. It had the 84, 85, 86, and 87. I'm doing them in order right now. I don't know that I will continue, but this is the 1986 one. That's my usually my to-go piece because it's easy to stitch on. This is another one that I don't know if I'll finish. It's not a give up yet, but it may become one. This is one that I started. It is from Just a Little Bit Country. You probably just saw some pattern. You won't be able to see it because I can't even see it when I sit in front of it. That's part of the issue. This is a hand-drawn pattern, guys, from 1981. This pattern's older than I am. Hand-drawn designs. And it's so, so hard to see. And then they're so intricate. It's so intricate. I don't know. It's this one right here. This was going to be either for me or my sister. I wasn't sure. It is a water wheel that, of course, you know, a mill that is in a college about a day's drive from us. Or you can get there in a day. And we used to go and see this area all the time. And it's just a memory for us. This is on a piece of 32 count lambswool wheel chult, which was my go-to fabric for a while. 32 count lambswool wheel chult. This one is not fun to stitch. I want the end product. I do not enjoy stitching it. Do not enjoy stitching it. So every one of these, so this building is made out of stone. And every one of these is a stone that is then backstitched around. And it's just so tedious. And then it's hand drawn. So then you have to, oh. Those were the days. Thank God for pattern paper and PDFs, right? It is on the line like the Lending Mystery. I don't know. I gotta fall back in love with it. I'm in love with the Lending Mystery. It's just I don't know what I would do with it. This one I know I would put on the wall. I just don't know that I could stitch it. I feel like my hair's growing over here. This is Nightmare. I did stitch on this one. This was an adopted whip from Emily. It is the Courtney Collection Nightmare. I think I showed this from my last video. This is what it looks like. This is what it looked like in 2022 when I picked it up. I didn't realize how much progress I had gotten. I mean, I know the number was high, but until I was looking, I was like, oh, wow, I really got some progress. And that's why these whip parades help so much. I put in 1,388 stitches on this one. This is on a Nina's Fabric. I don't know the fabric name, but I will tell you. I have it in here. I think, no I do not. I have it somewhere. And then it's Bon Bon by Nina's Threads. And then Pine Needles by Dinky Dyes is the turquoise to make that look tarnished. And that. I'm going to show one more before my time runs out. And then I will go and really upload part two and try not to delete it. Looks like I need to charge my battery again. Spring Quaker. Another of the Rosewood Manor Spring Quaker, you know, season Quakers. Not touched. Stitched in the called for Valdani and the called for threads. Are you ready for this vast amount of progress, guys? Are you ready? Not even a whole motif. Motif. That was really country. Not even a whole motif, though. That's it. I won't get them all four done this year. I do love stitching these, and I can see these up in my house too. Okay, so I'm gonna pause now to put these away, edit this part of the video, and come back for more. And I'm back. with a wardrobe change. This video has it all. Truth be told, it's the next day. I sat down last night. I've been editing the video in chunks as I go to where I don't have this whole long video to edit. And I sat down to start dropping the pictures in last night and was just done. Like, was done. The cough was getting worse because it's always worse at night. I was like, between my cough and then maybe being tired, I'm just going to stop. So I saved where I was, left the stuff out. My husband came home from work this morning and was like, what in the world happened in your room? I was like, yeah, I'm not done with the video yet. So I've had sleep, changed clothes, bath, got coffee. I have a sick kid at home. I say sick. He's not like contagious sick. Just some stomach issues. I'm pretty sure we either have a bladder kidney infection or either need some acid reflux. Random, right? It's a kid. It's hard to tell. He's always had stomach issues when he was born. Really long story short, his stomach ruptured. He's had surgery, the gastric sleeve. He has acid reflux a lot because of that. I think we're going to have to go back on the acid reflux medicine. Then he had a kidney cyst or has a kidney cyst that sometimes causes kidney issues. We're just going to get everything checked, make sure we're good. We take this kind of stuff serious. He's fine, but we're just going to be seen with the doctor and make sure we're good. Sip of coffee. Hope you have coffee. Good morning. Where it is for me. I'm not used to filming in the daylight, so I don't know how. I'm like really worried about this lighting. So anyway, we're going to jump in and just keep going. The first one is Green Damsel. This is an ink circles pattern. This is what it will look like when it's finished. I have not worked on this one, so I don't need a before picture. I'll tell myself part of that. This is stitched on a 36-piece count of, I want to say, oaken that I have. And I've pulled my own floss. One is a Victorian Mottos, the yellow, and then I have, I don't know, just some colors. Some that I had in my stash. And this is where I currently am. Green is up, I think. As a mandala, I guess it doesn't really matter which way is up. I'm about halfway through with the guys, I think. Oh no, not even close. Halfway through the centermost part. I forgot there was a border. That one can be finished this year. Summer Quakers. Another one in the... Did I already show Summer Quakers? I feel like I showed Summer Quakers. No. No. Not showing Summer Quakers. Not this time. This is what it will look like when it's finished. Again, did not stitch on this one. And I have even less done on this one. This is the called for Picture This Plus Even Weave. And then the called for Valdani's. Guys, not even a hole. Not even a whole one. But hey, it is what it is. Put some stitches in it. We're good. This dang pencil. Next is Winter Quakers. The last of the four. So I'm sure autumn, spring, and summer. Now here's winter. This is the one I was working on whenever Connor's stomach stuff was, or kidney stuff was going on. So I started it. It's just in a spot for me. This is on Picture This Plus 32 Count Dwarf in the Valdani's. I got a pretty good amount done. And then I realized that I didn't do one of the motifs correctly in that, like, I could have saved more thread, and because of that, now I haven't touched it again, right? That makes sense. I could have saved more thread, so now I haven't touched it. It's weird how we get these little things that give us almost like a mental block on these pieces. But there that is. I've got to go back and add around here some more color. What I might do is, with it being winter, work on winter Quakers. If I work, like, try to work on the appropriate season, I don't know. We'll see. But there's no way I'll get this done in a season. I don't know if I should pick one. What do you guys think? Should I pick one of these and work on it all year long, or should I work on them in their appropriate season? Audience participation. This is a new beginning. This was a style with Melody stitches. Who doesn't do floss tube anymore? And I don't even know if she stitches anymore. We're still in touch, but I think she got big into crochet and now doesn't stitch. This is a done by Abby Lane Designs. It's just Quakers. Quakers. Quaker motifs. This is in on a random Witchelt fabric that is see-through, so it's probably 32 count. Probably 32 count lamb's wool, because that was my go-to fabric for the longest, and I still like it. So these so far are stitched up in a whole bunch of different dinky dyes and dinky dyes and what's the other name for dinky dyes? Because she sold and moved, and then anyway, they're thread packs. They're floss bits. They sometimes have random remnants. They'll have remnants of their silk for sale in random thread packs on Etsy. And I've purchased several of them, and that's what this is stitched in so far, and remnants of that. But then I was kind of running out of silks and was like, oh, you know, I'm kind of getting repetitive colors. Like, they're all turquoises, or all the greens, or all blues. And stupid me, hello, I can grab out of my color in cotton and add, because you can mix silk and cotton, right? Did not stitch on that one at all last year. Definitely want to stitch on it this year. And I'm just picking as I go, which was fun. I need to get back to that one. This is Thine is the Trick. This is a Prairie Schooler. I'm sorry, a Prairie Moon. I have a working copy. Because I try to make working copies of all my patterns. I think I've said this already. I don't know. But especially my out of print ones. This one I think you can get as a PDF again now. They have Thine is the Trick. And then, No Mine is the Trick. So there's a second version of this one. And this is stitched in all black. Did I work on this one this year? I did not. This is on a scrap of Hexing by Hand Dyed Fabrics by Stephanie. I'd originally gotten this based on what it looked like online to do Fairy Moon on by Mirabilia. I thought it looked like a morning sky, but then when I got it, I realized it looked more like Halloween-y. So I've got this one on here, and then another one that you'll see in a minute on the other side of this fabric, and then even a scrap in my stash, my Hopper needle minder, because oh my god, Hopper is amazing. Stranger Things, if you don't know. And this is a little floss keep that it's Kismet Stitches gave me. It's a wooden one. This is a Rosewood Manor. But it only holds one, so. I think you're supposed to, like, put your Valdani around it and then link it off, but I'm not doing it. This I did not work on. This is Proverbial Home by Hands On Design. This is an adopted whip from Connie. I've not stitched on it yet. I want to eventually. That is actually what it looks like. It says, by wisdom a house is built, and through understanding it is established. Through knowledge its rooms are filled with rare and beautiful treasures. So I'm going to continue this on. Again, I'm going to have to turn it on its side when I stitch. She's got it on some 14 count Aida, so it's going to be big and huge, and I love it. This is where it currently is. she's more than halfway through, so when I pick it up, I won't have very much to stitch on. It smells like her. I'm thinking about noticing. Oh. Like, if I have something from Emily, I know that I can smell Emily's half. And if I have something from Connie, I can smell her. Like, it's not even the... It's just a smell. I know my husband's clothes. I'm big about smells. This is another adopted whip from Connie. This is G Wiz 6. Let me see if I can show you what it looks like without showing you the pattern. I don't know. I think I may have a picture. It is kind of another backstitch type piece. She has started this on a blue piece of linen. And she's stitching it in most, or we are stitching it in most silk called roast beef. No, corned beef. And guys, this is so pretty. I don't know if it's going to show up well on the camera. It's never pictured well. I've not stitched on it. It's never pictured well. But the colors are amazing in person. It's so shiny that we... There, I turn off the light for just a second. There we go. Because that's the light it'll actually be in when you see it. But it's just so shiny. The silk is so shiny that it's hard to see with the bright light. But there that is. An adoptive whip. I want whips to be with old. Not even my own. Not even anybody else's. Okay, next is... So this is one called Color for Parrots. It was a new start last year. This is a gift to me from a coworker. I mentioned it in my last video. It is a stamped kit. Do what you will with those. Use at your own risk. Do some research. I did not see this one anywhere else on the internet. Like that another designer had done this one. Sometimes you can find them where they have been obviously stolen. I couldn't find this color for parrots. However, when I was looking for this one, I did see where somebody had told an artist, hey, Joy Sunday is using your artwork in a cross stitch kit. I need you to know. And the artist responded and they said, yes, I'm aware they've gotten permission. So that made me feel a little better. But it's a stamped kit. It's not one that I work often. This is one. These are going to be my retirement stitches because she's given me a few more. That when I'm too old to see well, like when I just need to just be able to stitch, I'll work on these stamped because these are so easy. You just X. Or if I'm not feeling well, like when I switch shifts, sometimes I want to stitch, but I don't feel like thinking about stitching. So, but I've stitched part of this bird. And then all of this perch or branch, except for the end of their own. But I don't even have this first guy finished. And I've got put in for Colorful Parrots. I've put in 962 stitches on this one. So, it's got a lot of stitches. A lot of stitches. This one I just kind of hold in hand right now. I may change that. I'll roll it up and stitch. I may change that. I may end up putting it on a hoop or something. I think I'll get through it quicker. But the fabric is stiff enough that even a very much so married to a Q-snap hoop or something stitcher can stitch in hand. I'm not a hand stitcher. This piece is in a huge bag. This is Lady of the Flag, guys. I had to restart this. So, I purchased a We the People fabric from Fabric Flare. Was stitching on it. Noticed that I was getting closer and closer to the bottom. Counted it out. I don't know if it shrunk in the dyeing process or if it was mislabeled. But what was supposed to be a certain count does not count out to that amount. No fault to anybody. It just doesn't count out to that. So then I repurchased Another We the People fabric from, oh, I can see the designer's thing. I can see it. Who is it by? Primitive Hair. Primitive Hair. Purchased a piece of their We the People fabric online. Restarted it. Started it upside down. Had to frog it. Flip it over and start it again. Because, you know, I can't ever do anything easy. This is a conversion piece. I'm going to stitch this in the green colorway because it reminds me of the Statue of Liberty when it's stitched that way. And she reminds me of the Statue of Liberty anyway. And also, when my grandfather immigrated from Greece many, many, many years ago, over a century ago, that's what he said the first, he knew, because, you know, he was on that ship. It was dangerous. He said he knew he was going to be safe once he saw her and always loved the Statue of Liberty. So it's also for my great-grandfather that we called Pop. So it's almost like a memorial piece, even though I didn't know him. But that's where she is. This piece this year is the one that I will stitch if no other categories come up. However, I will also try to put her in some categories because while I will not get her finished, I definitely want to get some progress on her. I just want to. I'm a little concerned. I have bead conversions and floss conversions. But I've got to look at the Krynek and make sure I don't need to change. Because the Kryniks are all gold. But I think all the Kryniks are in her hat. Her crown, not a hat. And around the bottom. And I've got to make sure that I don't need to convert any Kryniks to green as well. I really need to get this in a smaller bag. This bag is way too big for this piece. But it is what it is. So that is it for all of my mesh bags. I am now diving into my actual project bags. So I don't have too much more. We're making good progress. This is a new start this year. It was, or is, Big Round Zipper by Bent Creek. When this first came out, it was released in sections. And then I purchased all these sections to make one big piece. I fell in love with this. Again, another one that I fell in love with at a little, like an L&S. As a model, but they didn't have it. I was intimidated by it because it is so huge. I then put it on a wish list and just wouldn't get it because, like, there's six parts. No. Yeah. Six parts. And I was like, I'm not spending that much money. Then my husband and my son got it for me for my birthday last year, so I started it. This is stitched on 18 count raw linen, one over two with the number 5 braid DMCs. And this way is up. I need to put my up. This is where I currently am. I did finally sit down because I had a frog and I gridded with some sulky pink sliver to where I can tell if I'm in the right spot or not. Love working on this piece, guys. Love it. And again, another Hopper Needle Minder by a company that no longer makes them. It says, mornings are for coffee and contemplation. I agree. That's one of my favorite quotes by him. He's, so those of you that don't watch it, Hopper is the police chief and there's something going on in the town and his assistant is like his secretary or whatever, the little police, tiny, tiny police department. Like he walks in the door and she's badgering about what was going on. He's like, mornings are for coffee and contemplation. And she keeps on, coffee and contemplation. It's just a very, don't talk to me until I've had my coffee moment. This is Needles Dance. Oh, and that bag was gifted to me by Lori, Organic Granny. Another one that I wish would do videos. This one was gifted to me. Was this one, maybe? Is this a mommy bag? Or, I know this was a gift from Emily. I feel like it's one that she made. Yes, this is the one that she made. This is the one that took a trip around the world. And this was a limited edition kit from Ink Circles and Hands-On Design. This is what it will look like when it's finished. I did not stitch on this year. I'm doing the darker version. I got the kit. I think you can get the design, but I purchased the kit. It's on this lovely blue Aida, and it even came with a needle minder. My camera's struggling to focus this morning. It's like me is struggling this morning. Another one that could easily be done this year. All of these could easily be done this year, right? Next is Matters Choice. I don't know where I got this bag. This is this is what it looked like when it's finished. Plus, I don't have the pattern here. I'm stitching on this on a color and cotton patina. It's a 36 count linen. This is what it looked like before this year because I did stitch on this one. I put in a whole 417 stitches. I don't know what the pattern is. And this is where I currently am. This is stitched with a Threadworks brown cloth. I'll tell you the number in just a second. Guys, I love it. I love the way the brown pulls out the brown of the fabric. I love it. And that is one of my favorite needle minders. My soul is fed with needle and thread. Very true. The Threadworks color is 1037. Transpose some numbers there. But it's kind of a browny black color. This bag was gifted to me by Making Live Count, Dina, or Dina North. This is Quaker Samplings 3. And Ellen Chester, or Love Thy Needle. With my needle. We have With Thy Needle, and this is With My Needle. Ellen Chester. Stitched, and then again, a Threadworks red. And then Emily made me this thread keep. I don't know the number. I knew the name. I'd have to look online to get the number for you. So I'm not breaking the law. I have a red work sampler. Guys, I stitched on this one this year. I put in 789 stitches on this one this year. That is where it will end. I'm going to do the rest of the alphabet, and then I will have start the motifs. This is a needle minder that was a gift from Belinda. It's got a lovely little dragonfly. I did not realize that this video was going to take over a night to do. I think I can get one more. Yeah. This is Cinnamon Stars. This is in a Stranger Things bag. A Vic and Button. Stitch and Button bag. And then all the little people. Letters. Mm. This is stitched on 32 count raw MCG textiles linen. I don't have a problem with it. Cinnamon Stars. I did not touch it last. I've not touched this thing since I started it. I know which way's up, though. I think, yeah. That's the whole thing. This was a start in 2020 with Sarah from Our Stitchy Kingdom. And I need to stitch on it more this year. And I'm going to pause here and go upload and edit this part of the video. Okay. Hopefully the last section. Let's see. I don't know if you can hear it. My neighbor is out working in his yard. Another reason I don't do daytime videos is he likes to use all of his farm equipment every day. Even though he doesn't have a farm. Anyway, that's a whole other issue. Continuing right along. Pandemic Sampler. This is what it will look like when it's finished. I did not stitch on this one last year. This is stitched on a 36 count Lakeside Linens in silver. And the called for DMC. I just need to stitch on this more. This way. This is where I am. Tarnished silver. There we go. And then this is just a random steampunk butterfly needle miter. Nothing to see here on this one, but still one of my whips. And this is another stitch and button bag. Oh my goodness, this fabric. Like, I need a quilt in this. And then this inside, it's just a purple inside fabric. There it is. But this out, oh my gosh, that's so pretty. Before I forget, let me go ahead and do Tree of Hope. I can't show you the actual progress because it's my daily 100 piece. I'm stitching on it 100 stitches a day. And if I don't finish the stitches, like, I'll stitch 100 stitches every day. If there's a day that I don't get 100 stitches in, I don't then, like, so if I don't stitch 100 stitches on Friday, I don't do 200 on Saturday. I'll do one thread length for Friday and then pick up on the Saturday with 100 stitches. I do that because of work. I don't always get to stitch at work. I think I mentioned this earlier, but anyway. I feel like when I was showing Pumpkin Swirl, I mentioned this. But then, again, I did have the whole 30 minutes that got deleted, so I don't know if I told you that or not. But, there's that. This is stuck in this bag. Earthly Treasures by Plum Streak Samplers. This is what it will look like when it's finished. And I stitched nothing on this one this year. This one, again, is so close to a finish. It's ridiculous. Stitched in the called for floss on a piece of 36 count, I believe 36 count, maybe 32 count raw linen. That is where I am. I messed up here, but I customized up here, but you can't tell. I basically reversed some colors in the Stone Angel. Rakoa to the rescue. Guys, this cough. Like, I feel fine. I just can't get rid of the cough. I don't know why. So, this is just in a bag that has an M on it. It's seen better days. I probably will not put a project back in this one when I'm done. Because it's hard to get the pieces in and out. I'll do that later. That may become a supply piece. Well, it's literally sticking to that. It must have a magnet in it. This is Henna Mandala. This is a project bag that was a gift from Kelly, my friend Kelly. I don't get to see her very often. this is what it will look like when it's finished. I did stitch on this one. This is my to-go piece for a while until I started the, until I got more into the Prairie Schooler Santas as my to-go piece. I stitched 1,517 stitches on this piece. This is what it looked like before. This is on a piece of Aida that I dyed myself. It was kind of an off-white color. And then I dyed it myself. As I'm over halfway finished. This is was a sow with Eclectic Possessions and Casey from Southern California Stitchers. And just a daisy, colorful daisy mandala. Needle minder. But yeah, I mean, so close. The DNC this is in is the same one Emily's using. And I tell myself every time that I'm going to write down the number, and I never do. It's just one of the DMC variegated flosses variations. And I need to remember to write it down. But it just reminds me of the henna tattoos, so. This one is Stormtroopers. It's a kit. It's in the kitted floss. But not the kitted fabric. I stitched on this on the way to. A little bit while we were in Disney and on the way home from Disney. This is what it looked like when I started this year. And I put in 461 stitches. I have no clue about this fabric. It was a scrap that was gifted to me. I want to say it's a 32 count. It may be a 28 count even weave. Either way, it will fit. This is another one that's for my son. Eventually, it's in a stitch and button bag. I mean, how can you not? And I'll probably always end up having some kind of Star Wars piece because my husband and my kid both love Star Wars. This is Horror Movie Sal. So this is one that was Wolfpack Creations. It was a mystery stitch along. I'll insert the teaser here. I need to try to find the mock-up now that it's completed. And I need to download all the patterns before the group is closed. This is the other piece of the hexing by Fabrics by Stephanie. For this one, I put in, this is what it looked like at the beginning of this year. I put in 6,605 stitches on this. And guys, I'm still not even halfway through. I love it. But there are always little things on some of my pieces that I've become a standstill on. So this one is Jeepers Creepers. So, here's the entire story. She started off with Jeepers Creepers. And that's what it was originally charted. Because of the director, she took Jeepers Creepers off. I won't get into that story. But I kept it because I was like, oh, that was one of mine and my husband's date nights. We saw Jeepers Creepers 2 together. He went and took another girl to Jeepers Creepers. But we saw Jeepers Creepers 2 together. She inserted Pet Cemetery. And I love the Pet Cemetery one. I'm going to stitch it up, complete it, and see about trying to fit the Pet Cemetery in there somewhere. If not, I may take out the I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do. Nonetheless, as of now, it's staying the way it is. I'll stitch it up and be done. My husband has made a rule, though, that I'm going to have to watch all of these horror movies if I'm stitching them. So, at some point, I guess I'll be watching horror movies. I don't like scary movies. Hang on, let me show you this first. I don't dislike horror movies. Things like It and Scream and stuff like that don't generally bother me. They don't scare me. Thrillers scare me. One of the scariest movies I've seen is The Strangers. Many years ago, it could happen. Like, it's about people being bad to people. Those bother me more than It or Jason or Friday the 13th, because those are so unbelievable. I just don't like slasher films, but some of these are classics, so this isn't a Nightmare Before Christmas piece. Oh, look at Jack and Sally. That is one of my favorite movies. And it's got this beautiful black background. I watch it at Halloween and at Christmas because it's both. You know, just use an excuse to watch. This bag was a gift from Emily, and in it is Seeking Refuge, and I did not work on that one this year. My dog is barking. I have to go take care of that. This is what it will look like when it's finished. Didn't stitch on it this year. I need to work on this more. This is on a, oh my gosh, I lied to Emily. This is on a 40 count linen. I told her I never stitched on 40 count. Because I told her I was looking at a piece of fabric on eBay that I was convinced that I wanted to get. And I was telling her to tell me no. And she said, do you even like 40 count? I said, I never stitched on it. And she said, then no. I have stitched on 40 count. I did not know that. Now I'm going to have to go back and get the piece of fabric. This is all that I've done. It's the beginning of the border. I'm stitching 1/2. This is a 40 count Newcastle Tuscan clay by Silk Weavers. Guys, I love Silk Weavers fabric. I guess it's a good thing that I don't live closer to New Jersey, because I would be buying their fabric all the time, as it is. Unless I can find it on eBay, I don't get it generally, because as wonderful as Silk Weavers is, I'm going to tell myself that they're busy and their shipping process is not great when you order from them. If you order from them, you will get your product, but you will have to keep on them about it. This is a bag from the lovely Eskismet Stitches. Guys, oh my gosh. This is Beachcomber. I've worked on this since my last video, but I didn't show it because I knew I was going to do the whip update. Anyway, you don't care about all that. This year I put in, this is what it looked like in the beginning. This is what it looked like when I finish. I'm using this actually on the PDF. It was a PDF. I printed it out. Now I have Pattern Keeper, so I use it on Pattern Keeper, but I still carry the chart with me. So this is what mine will look like. This is what it originally is supposed to look like. So if you notice, mine is more brown than the original. So when I saw this online, it looked more brown, and I got it to stitch for my bedroom, because my bedroom is in blues and browns and and turquoises. It makes sense. Beachcomber sands are going to be kind of beige and pink. But then when I got it, I wanted the more browns. Emily and I converted some of the colors. To make it more the colorway that I wanted. If anybody is interested, I'll be glad to give you the conversion. Just ask. And I'll give you a conversion. This is stitched on, again, the 32 count raw MCG linen. So if you guys hate it, I don't mind it. And this is where I am now. My belly is growling. I swear I've eaten breakfast, but my belly is growling. And this needle minder is a black butterfly. I don't know why, but when I was stitching on this piece, and Emily helped me on it. This was the year that Emily and I started all the things. We were constantly messaging each other in 2020 saying, hey, I'm starting this. Hey, I'm starting this. She started a Caroline Manning piece as well. Hers is it's forest. It's greens. I love these Caroline Manning pieces. And there are so many colorways that I love, but they're all kind of the same. I don't know if I'll do any, like, a lot more. I don't know. We'll see. But, so, because that's a sal with her, technically, because she's got the green one, I use that black butterfly, because I don't know why, but that black butterfly kind of reminds me of Emily. This bag was a gift from Chelsea Alesh. She has YouTube videos. She's not done a video in a while. This is my early days. This was also a sal piece with Emily. This is a new start this year, so I don't have a beginning piece because it was blank. She gifted me this piece for my birthday in 2020. It's stitched for in the called for colors. There is one that I'm doing a change on. And then I've got a mess up. And so far, I'm going to leave it. Again, a customization. This is supposed to be this green color. Focus. Focus, focus. Come on, focus. See? Green. I accidentally stitched it in this brown. But I think I'm going to leave it. Because, I mean, I'm gonna leave it and keep going and see. I'm going to move over and see how it looks. It's just that one section. I think I'm going to leave it. Because it's only that one flower. And it's most of that. That's like most of that. I'm going to leave it. I'm pretty sure. Again, if I stitch the others and it looks really weird, I'll take it out. This needle minder. I'm not sure where the name of it came from, but it is Jack and Sally as Mary Poppins, and just gotta love it. Gotta love it. I put in 1,224 stitches on this one. See, some of these, like, I either didn't touch it at all, or I put a lot in. It's birthday's coming up. I need to stitch on it today. Tomorrow. This is Sunflower Mandala. It was a new start at the very end of 2020. This was a gift from Belinda. This is what it looks like when it's finished. I have not stitched on this one this year. I do want to stitch on it. This is on a Witchelt 32 count Witchelt. I want to say lamb's wool. I don't think it's lamb's wool. I don't know. It may be the mocha. It's a Witchelt fabric. And again, some people hate the Witchelt fabric. I don't mind it at all. This is where I am. And I do have the silks. She even gave to me the silks, guys. And the beads. I'm really excited. I love that piece. I love the colors. Hang on, I think my kid's calling. And I am back. Okay. So, next up is Dragonfly Fairy. This bag was gifted to me from Kelly. It is a needle necessities bag. Jan's needle stitching necessities. Jan's Stitching Necessities bag. I think the pattern was a gift from Belinda, but I think I kitted up the DMC myself, because this is stitched in the called for DMC. But I think she may have sent me the specialty fibers. Maybe that's what it was. This is stitched on a piece of Silk Weaver's Morning Mist. It's half of it. I have the other half in my fabric stash. It's a 32 count Morning Mist by Silk Weaver's. I did not stitch on this one this year. This is what it will look like when it's finished. And I believe Belinda is working on this one as well. And I need to work on it more. This is where she is. And I can call her a she, because last night I was calling all my fabrics she's. I'm not sure. But this is a fancy lady, so. I have picked up this other piece of fabric for two or three different projects. I'm going to decide not to use them. Because it's like I save it. Like, I get a piece of fabric that I really, really like, and then I'm afraid to use it. Because, I don't know, what if something else is perfect for it later and I've, you know, used it. This is an A International Arrivals bag that I got at the Container Store, guys. If you like this type of bag, it's amazing. It's got this little mesh front. And then this is canvas. And it's huge. It's technically like a supply bag, but I use it for this. This is a gift from Organic Granny. It is Butterfly, Dragonfly, Ladybugs, and Bees, Oh My, by M Designs, chart number 135. Not 135, just chart number 35. I am using DMCs, because that's what it called for. Except it did call for one silk or Vera Soie silk, which I'm just using the DMC. And then it called for a Thread Gatherers Silk and Color Whippoorwill Lane. And I think I subbed that for just a I don't know what I'm using that for. Do I have that one? Oh, I subbed it for a Week Style Works Madras. Come on, focus. Here we go, just put it there. This is on Buttercup by Under the Sea Fabrics. It is an opalescent. And it is a 32 count linen. And I have done one whole bee. And then I've got this a tribal dragonfly needle minder. No stitches on this one. Again, I've not touched this one since I started it. And I started this one back in, I want to say like 2019? A while back ago. No reason. I just haven't picked it up. Saved a project from falling off the table. This is my very old sampler, is what we call it. It's actually from a magazine chart. I did a giveaway of some of these, and one person never responded, and I still have that fabric, that magazine. I may need to do another giveaway if I still have it. This is what it will look like when it's finished. It is in the Cross Stitch and Country Crafts. I don't know which edition. I can give you all the information the next time I'm working on it. Oh, this is in a Mamaly bag. And I've got it in the called for DMCs, except some of them, they're all variegated. They're all the DMC variegated chart, the colors. Some of them have been changed because they don't make them anymore. This was a group, Jen Upton, started to go through and find some of the samplers in the old magazines and update them many years ago. This is where I am, and I've didn't stitch on it this year, but I've stitched on it more than my initial start. I just need to get it out and work on it. It's going to be beautiful. It's gonna be amazing, and I just need to work on it more. 32 count roll MCG linen. Let's get this one out of the way because it keeps trying to jump out of the bag. So this is a Garon Toten Bags bag. It's Mickey Mouse Paris. It's huge. But it has a huge project in it. I blame Ellen. Maximum Cross Stitch for this one. This is Dutch Beauty. A huge piece. Guys, I even have backup floss. So it needs this big bag. As Dee Stitcher said, she has one that is... She's doing the Rosewood Alphabet sampler. And she calls it her blanket piece. This is my blanket piece, guys. I mean, it's humongous. So, did I stitch on this one this year? I did not. I will next year, though. That is where I currently am. I got a pretty good amount. The last time I worked on this, I was in a virtual chat with Ellen. So many notes. I'm bad if I'm charting and get a phone call to take notes on the back of my project. That's why I keep working copies. This is Mini Mandala. This is what it looks like when it's finished. This is, I got this from Scott many Christmases ago in the kit from European Cross Stitch. This is Mini Mandalas 2. It's got 3 mandalas. This is the second one in the grouping. This is where I am. Didn't stitch on it last year. I've got all the specialty threads too. But that's it. If you're going to do a Mirabilia, wow. If you're gonna do a Chatelaine, I definitely recommend getting the PDF because you can zoom in. The printed charts are kind of hard to read. And this is in a Momly bag. This one is Be Thankful. This is a bag that was gifted to me from the wonderful Marlene at Stitching by the Lake. This is another kitted project. You can get just the pattern too. It is Diane Authors, so Little House Needleworks. But this kit is through Imaginating Designs. I don't know if you can still get the kit or not. Stitching it in the Call for DMC or Call for Colors on the kitted 18 count Aida fabric. And I did not work on this one. And I will tell you why this one's become, I've got most of the, do I have all the words? I have all the words complete. The basket, guys, that basket is so wrong. But it's okay. And now all I have to do is the vine. But there's a lot of back stitch on this one. And that is what's kept me from working on this one as much. Is anticipating the back stitch. But I mean, I could finish this one this year. So many of my projects are like so close to finish. It's like I hit a certain spot. And then I just move along. Guys, the end is in sight. I will get this done in this section. Another Momly bag. Love her color choices when she makes bags. The Village at Hawk Run Hollow. Guys. What it will look like when it's finished. I don't have the charts in here because of there's so many pieces. And in fact, I don't even have all the DMC in here. I pull out the DMC that is on the block and then put it away when I'm not using it because there are so many. This fuzz. I just panicked. There was something black on my fabric and I was like, oh. I did stitch on this one this year. This is what it looked like at the beginning of 2022. And I put in 228 stitches on this one. So, I again had a middle block for this one. I do have a little bit of something on there, but it'll be stitched over. I think you'll be able to see it. They had misspelled Isaiah, and it bothered me. And then I finally figured out how to chart it to where it was spelt correctly, and I fixed it. So now I've just got to do the leaves of the Weeping Willows, and then I'll be able to move on to the third block. When I started this back in 2020, I was going to do a block a month. Yeah, right. 2 years later, and I haven't even done 2 blocks in 2 years. This is on a Witchelt 32 count fabric. I don't know what color. It's like white mocha, I think. Look at it. It's fabric. Oh, it's so pretty. Ooh, next is another one that I blame on Ellen. This is the Zimmerman coverlet from Modern Folk Embroidery. So this was what the entire piece was supposed to look like, but I cheated and I stitched just to do this one little section. I've cut it down instead of doing the three repeats. This is on a no-name, very tight 36, 30, between a 36, 32, and 40, probably count linen. I'm stitching this all in DMC 3847. I did not. Oh, I did. So this is what it looked like before 2022 started. And I put in 1,013 stitches. 1,013 on this piece. Those of you that work in the medical field will know 1,013 when I giggled. Because this piece was very frustrating. I had to frog and redo, and then I got it going, and I was good to go. Love it, love it, love it. And we'll stitch on it more soon. And then this is my Medusa needle minder. I chose this one because usually whenever I do any kind of chat with Ellen, that's what my hair looks like. Y'all, curly hair, it's either fixed or it's crazy. There is no in between. Oh, dang, my tag broke already. Fix that. Next is my Fantasia Vinette. Apparently I've been saying that incorrectly. Vic at Stitching Button, let me know that. This is what it will look like when it's finished. Charted as is with all the kitted up stuff. Except I changed out their metallic for iconic. Very similar, just a better quality. This is what it looked like at the start of 2022. And I put in 316 stitches in this one. I don't know why I've not stitched a Mickey yet. I came down here in the green. I think I'm going to stitch everything and then stitch Mickey last. I don't know why. I think because I'm looking forward to Mickey. And I've heard if I stitch Mickey, then I won't stitch the background. But if I do the background first, then Mickey will be my reward. Because I love Mickey Mouse. I loved him as a kid. I mean, I'm not like, you know, reading and stitching in love with Disney. But I love Mickey Mouse. Two more, guys. Two more. The end is in sight. This was a new start this year. This is a salve with Sammy J Stitches. Shannon, I don't think she does floss tubes. And then the silver stitcher. And she doesn't do videos. She did do videos. She doesn't do them anymore. Hang on. It's better just to go ahead and cough and get it out. This is the Blue Flower Moonlight Sampler. OMG. I saw this online and fell head over heels for it. And then I was at a stitch thing at Dina Half Stitch Cross Stitch's house. And somebody was stitching it. And I fell in love with it even more, and I had to start it. So I got it, and I started it with them. This is on the other part of that Lakeside Linen Tarnished Silver that my pandemic sampler is on. I'm stitching this in mostly the charted colors. I changed a few of them to look more like the cover piece. And the next time I show this, if you're interested, let me know. And the next time I show it, I will show my conversions. I had to get my golden girls needle minder. This is from Stitch and Button. And this year I put in 714 stitches on this. Shannon is like almost done. Sammy is stitching away. I've got to catch up. But that is where I am. I fell in love with a saying, too. The saying is, though my soul may set in darkness, it will rise in perfect light. Though my soul may set in darkness, it will rise in perfect light. I have loved the stars too fondly to be fearful of the night. And I love the little redhead. Like, love that she's redheaded. And all the little animals. It's got possums. All the little... Oh, I love it. And last, but certainly not least, is Christmastide. This was in a Mommily bag. This is a sow that I'm doing with Emily. And this is stitched on... I think it's on the called for fabric. Nope. This is on... I don't know what this one is. I know it's a witch hold. I don't know what the color is. Amber, maybe? I don't know. So I got this one out of a Better Home and Gardens book. But you can purchase the fabric, or I'm sorry, the fabric. The chart on her Etsy store. It is by Threadwork Primitives. Mm-hmm. And this is a cross-stitch Christmas, Better Home and Gardens, a cross-stitch Christmas. So this is what it will look like when it's finished. It's, again, salt box houses, right? Are those all salt box houses, that shape? And I'm stitching it in the called for, is that the inside or is it called for? It calls for weak style works and gentle arts. And I'm stitching in the call for colors, except I think I changed out one of them. I don't remember which one I changed out. I'd have to look and see. I think it was Oscar. Is it called for Oscar? Next time I work on it, if you're interested, I'll tell you. But these are the colors. Love those colors. Perfect prim colors. And this is where I currently am. That's either end. And I'm actually starting in on some of the houses. And I did not work on this one this year. So many of them that I did not work on this year. I don't remember what this one was though. That's good. This is in parts of my projects. Okay, so all of my whips are now shown. I will give you my statistics because I kept them. I counted all my stitches last year, give or take, you know. So I had 9 starts and I had 11 finishes. I will insert those after I give the stats. And I stitched 49,955 stitches. I was adding a digit there. I had 117 days that I did not stitch at all. And I had 248 days that I stitched. I put at least 500 stitches on 27 of my projects. I touched 43 projects and did not touch 41. I started 2022 with 74 projects, and I ended with 72 projects. My largest stitch month was September with 6,197 stitches, and my smallest was July with 2,360. Oddly enough, July was also my month with the least amount of stitches. But that is it. Those are all my stats. I've got a list of new starts and finishes, and I will show you the finishes. Now, let me stop and pause, get my finishes out, and then get the photos if I need them, because some of them were gifts. So, be right back. So, I'm back with my finishes, and I've got them in order. There's one that I'll have to show you a picture of, because I don't have it. So, the first one I finished was on January the 4th. This is Pugs, Not Drugs. Well, this is Tiny Modernist. Don't hold me to that, though. It was a struggle bus piece. And then on February the 2nd, I finished my first Prairie Schooler Santa. This was 1984. Teeny tiny. I could have gotten another one, and I may still go back and try to get a second one on here. I don't know yet. And then March the 31st, I finished my first of the Frog Fairies. Not Prairie Schooler Fairies. This is Frog Fairy. They've got a sparrow, a rabbit, and a snail. I've got them kitted up and ready to go too. I may start one of those this year. And then next was Adventure Awaits, my nephew's birth sampler. It was finished on April the 6th. And then we have Giving Thanks. This was a kit. I finished this on April the 16th, 2 days before my birthday. It was a good birthday present. And guys, it was on 20 count sand. I've got so much more of this fabric left. And then I didn't have another finish until June when I finished House of Flowers by Bent Creek. This is what got me into all of their zipper kits. I'd already seen the big round zipper, but this one I fell in love with stitching over the one over two with the pearl cotton. And then my big finish of the year, on August the 26th, I finished Starry Night. Guys, done, complete. Let's see, in Starry Night, I guess I should tell you how much I stitched on each of these for a finish, right? To finish Starry Night, I put in 8,028 stitches. To finish Adventure Awaits, I put in 1,072 stitches. Frog Fairy, 1,184 stitches. Giving Thanks, 967 stitches. House of Flowers, 1,637 stitches. Pugs Not Drugs was a whole 206 stitches. Like, that was sitting ready to be done. P.S. Santa, the Preschooler Santa 84, the first one, 1,129 stitches. Haven't shown that one yet. That's all of those. Next is my Prairie Schooler Santa 85, which I put in 2,598 stitches on this one. I don't have as much room on this one to start a new one because I started in the middle. Next is Fall is Greater. This was a start and a finish. And I put in 2,285 stitches. I can't read my own handwriting, guys. This is on another Witchelt piece of fabric. I can tell by the way it feels. And then Thankful Quaker, I put in 1,684 stitches. And last but not least is my yellow sub. And I put in 4,279 stitches. So, even though I had a lot of projects, sorry, my voice is done. Even though I had a lot of projects that I didn't touch, the ones that I did touch, I put a lot in. And I think 11 is my record for finishes. Maybe I'll have more for 2023. We'll see. My issue is I have a lot of big, big projects. Guys, if you're here, you survived my whip parade. And, thank you. I survived too. It only took 2 days to stitch, or to do 2 days to stitch, as if. I will come back possibly next week or the week after. Trying to be better, trying to do better with an update video for January, maybe a mid-January update. We'll see. We'll see where I am with my stitching. I want to have enough to show you, but then I don't want to have so much that it's overwhelming. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you made it this far, you're a trooper. If you're still watching my videos after I only made 3 last year, I'm trying to do better this year. And if you're new, please subscribe. like, comment. I love the comments. I try to interact with all the comments and reply. If you have any questions, put them, you know, just ask, and I'll try to answer them to the best of my ability. As always, guys, take care and happy stitching.